Everybody, this is lecture for topic 9, ACT3110. This topic is about budgeting. Okay, in this topic, you will learn about definition, usage, and type of budget, flexible budget and performance report, comparison between actual performance and budgeted items. Okay, these are among the things that you will see in this topic. Okay, let's see the introduction about this topic. So first, what is a budget? Budget is a cost for a business by outlining the plans of the business in financial terms. I think most of you know what is a budget. A country has a budget. Like Malaysia, we have the Malaysian budget will be discussed in the parliament at the end of October, I think. Sometime in October. So also, every person always has a personal budget. When you receive your allowance, you will have a budget. How much you will spend for the tuition fee, how much you will spend for the living costs, how much you will spend for the accommodation, entertainment, etc. So in accounting, a business should have a budget to outline its future operation and profit, etc. Okay, for a business, there are at least three objectives of budgeting. There are three reasons or objectives why a business uses budget. First is to establish specific goals. So budget is used to show to everybody in the company what is the thing that the business want to achieve in the future. Executing plans to achieve the goals. So budget can be used as a tool or a guide for everybody in the business in doing or in about how to achieve the goals of the business. What is the thing that the workers have to do in a period of time? And then also periodically comparing actual results of the goals. So budget can be used to do what they call as a variance analysis. You can compare the actual results and the budgeted result. For example, you have a business, and then in your budget you have set that this year 2020 you want to achieve $1 million sales. So at the end of the year you can do comparison between the actual sales and the budgeted sales. Let's say at the end of the year your actual sales for your business is $1,050,000. So when you compare the actual sales and the budgeted sales, you will see that the difference is 50,000 favorable. It shows that your business is performing well in terms of sales. But let's say the budget is $1 million, but at the end of the year the sales is only $900,000. So the difference is $100,000 unfavorable. It shows that the business has to do something to improve in the future. So these are the three objectives of using budgets in a business. So basically this slide shows that the budget in accounting, budget can be used in all three basic functions of management or managers. budget can be used when the manager is planning for the business, and can be used when the manager directing or doing directing activities, and also can be used when the manager is doing the controlling activities. You have learned about these three basic functions of management, I think in topic 1. Sorry, in topic 6, I think. Okay, see here. How budget is used during the planning activity. So always remember, a management accountant works under a manager. So management accountant assists manager in doing management functions. So manager can use budget when they do the planning. So let's see here. Budgeting supports the planning process by requiring all organizational units to establish their goals for the upcoming period. These goals motivate individuals and groups to perform at high level. Planning also motivates employees to attain goals and improve overall decision making. Okay, so budget also can be used during the directing activities. A manager has to direct people. He has to ask people to do things for the business. So budget can be used during the directing activities. The budget can be used to direct and coordinate operations in order to achieve the stated goal. So, and then what else? Directing. Okay, now the controlling. How budget can be used in when manager do the controlling activities. So remember, what is the controlling activity? Controlling activity is when manager compare the actual data with the budgeted data of the business. If the, let's say the actual data is the sales is $1,050,000, the budgeted data is 1,000,000, so the situation is $50,000 favorable. So the manager has nothing to worry. But if the budgeted sales is $1,000,000, but the actual sales is $900,000 only, so the difference is $100,000 unfavorable. So the manager, if that is the situation, the manager has to do improvements. He has to make sure that in the next accounting year, he can perform at least equal to the budgeted sales. Okay, another thing that you have to know is budget can affect human behavior or workers' behavior. See here. Human behavior problems can arise if the budget goal is too tight and very hard for the employees to achieve. So let's say you have a business, if you set the budget at a very high point, and it is very difficult for the workers to achieve the target or budget, then the workers will become less motivated, because they know no matter how hard they work, they cannot achieve the budget or target that you have set. So be careful. So when you are a manager, do not set the budget or target very high. It can affect the motivation of the human or the workers. Another thing is, the budget goal is too loose and very easy for the employees to achieve. So, and also, you cannot set the budget very low. If you set the budget very low or set the target very low, then the workers become complacent because they know they can do whatever they want, but still they can achieve the target or budget. So you cannot put the budget very low. Okay, the good thing is, this is the good thing. Oh, so not yet. Okay, sometimes this is another thing. The budget goals of a business conflict with the objective of the employees. Sometimes you set a target for some employees, but it is against their personal wills or personal interests. So it doesn't work too. The best practice when you set a budget is you set a challenging target. Challenging target means you set the target or the budget at a point where if the workers work hard, he can beat the budget. But if the workers does not work hard, then he will perform below the budget. So that kind of target or budget will motivate the workers to work hard, because he knows or she knows if he or she works hard, then he can beat the budget and he can be seen as a performer in a business. So that is the point. Okay, let's see this one. Budgeting system. A variation of fiscal year budgeting called continuous budget maintains a 12-month projection into the future. Okay, this is about the budgeting practice. Okay, one of the budgeting practice is called continuous budgeting. If a business uses this continuous budgeting, it means that at every time during the year, the business has a one year budget. So the thing is like this. Okay, the business is always has 1 year budget. So let's see. Let's say the date is 2000. Okay, now it is supposed to be 2018 and 2019. So let's say now it is. Let's say this. It is now it is the month of February 2018. So if a business has or practice continuous budgeting, if now it is February 2018, the business has a budget from the month of February 2018 to the month of January 2019. And then let's say after the month of February has passed, when the month of March is started, the business will set the budget from March 2018 to the month of February 2019. And then after the month of March has passed, the business will develop a budget from the month of April 2018 to the month of March 2019. So that kind of practice is called continuous budgeting. The business will prepare budget, prepare 1 year budget at every time during the year. When the time pass, the business will prepare an extended budget, 1 year, another 1 year, another 1 year. So that one is called continuous budgeting. Another practice of budgeting is called zero-based budgeting. It requires manager to estimate sales, production, and other operating data as though operations are being started for the first time. So this, I think, the most common practice, zero-based budgeting. Zero-based budgeting means a company, if the company practices zero-based budgeting, before a new year is started, the business will prepare a one-year budget. Let's say this year is the year 2020. So at the end of the year 2020, maybe the month of November or December, a business that use zero-based budgeting, they will it will prepare a budget for year 2021. It will prepare the budget from 1st of January 2021, ended to be end, will be ended on the 31st of December 2021. Okay, that is zero-based budgeting. When the year 2021 is started, the business will use the budget until the end of the year 2021. And when the year 2022 is started, the business will use a new budget. So that kind of practice is called zero-based budgeting. Okay, another thing that you have to know under the practice related to budgeting is called a static budget. Okay, a static budget shows the expected result of a responsibility center only one activity for only one activity level. The budget does not change even if the activity changes. Static budget is used by many service companies and for some admin functions of manufacturing companies. Okay. We will see this slide after this. So we see what is the static budget first. Okay, this is an example of a static budget. The example is July 31st, 2008. It's supposed to be 2018. So let's say you are a manager and you use static budget for your department. So when you prepare the static budget, this is the format. So when you prepare budget for next year or next month, you have to write down the type of cost and the expected amount. For example, for this business, the department is assembly department budget. So assembly department, this is the budget, the static budget for this department. So see here, there are three costs: direct labor. The amount budgeted amount is 40,000. Electricity, the budgeted amount is 5,000. Supervisor salaries, the budgeted amount is 15,000. So the budgeted department cost for the July is for the year ending July 31st is 60,000. This is what the budget is. This budget is called as static budget. So what is the good thing about the static budget? The static budget is simple. All expenses are budgeted as fixed costs. So if somebody asks you to prepare a static budget for your department or for your business, it is very simple. You just list all the costs with the expected or budgeted amount for each cost. Very simple. But the weakness is a static budget does not adjust for changes in revenues and expenses that occur as volume change. Static budget is like a fixed cost. If the activity or quantity of production is different compared to your estimate, then the budgeted cost is still same. It does not change. So that is the weakness. It does not adjust for changes in revenue and expenses that occurs as volume or quantity change. Okay, the opposite of the static budget is the practice of using flexible budget. Flexible budget show the expected result of a responsibility center for several activity levels. A flexible budget is especially useful in estimating and controlling factory costs and operating expenses. Okay, this is the example of a flexible budget. See here, this flexible budget, the example is for the same department that you have seen in the previous slide. It is for the assembly department. For the year ending 31st of July 2000, supposed to be 2018. So if the department uses a flexible budget, then the budgeted the budget should look like this. First, you see here, in the budget, the first thing that you will have to write or to do is to show the unit of production related to the budgeted cost. So here in this example, there are three level of production. Level 1 is 8,000 unit, level 2 9,000 unit, level 3 is 10,000 units. So then you prepare the budget according to the level of activity or the quantity of production. Here you can see that the budgeted costs are divided into variable cost and fixed cost. Okay, the variable cost will change when the quantity or unit of production changes. See here, if the for the direct labor is $5 per unit. When the level of production is 8,000, the cost is 40,000. When the level of production is 9,000, the cost will increase to 45,000. When the level of production is at 10,000, the direct labor cost will increase to 50,000. So variable cost will increase when the quantity of production increases. But for fixed cost, the amount is fixed. No matter how many unit you produce, you have to pay the same amount for fixed cost. So let's see there. The total fixed cost is same every month. At every level of production, the fixed cost is equal. It's same, 16,000. So when total cost are total variable cost plus the total fixed cost. So this is an example of flexible budget. So you have to know how to prepare a flexible budget. If I ask you to prepare a flexible budget, you have to know how to prepare it. So always remember the format. The first thing that you have to show is to show the unit of production or level of activities. See here, there are three levels and there are three quantities, and then you have to show the variable cost and the fixed cost, and then the total department cost or total budgeted cost. Okay, so what is the good thing about this flexible budget? Okay, flexible budget provides information needed to analyze the impact of volume changes on actual operating results. The flexible budget allows a manager to revise the amount if the quantity of production is different compared to the estimate. Let's say you are a manager. At first, you estimate your production unit is next month is 10,000. But when the month is ended, you found that your actual production is 11,000. So if you use a flexible budget, you can change the budgeted cost, and you can compare the actual cost and the budgeted cost for 11,000 unit of production. That is a good thing about the flexible budget. If you use a static budget, even though the quantity of actual production is different compared to your estimate, you cannot adjust the budgeted cost. You have to refer to the same budgeted cost. But the weakness of a flexible budget is flexible budgeting requires greater research into cost. There must be a differentiation between fixed and variable cost. So the weakness of flexible budget is it is a bit difficult to prepare, because when you want to prepare a flexible budget, you have to categorize your cost, your department cost or your business cost, into fixed cost and variable cost. Sometimes it is very difficult to identify which one is variable cost and which one is fixed cost. Sometimes some cost has both the fixed component and variable component. So maybe it is quite a bit difficult to prepare the flexible budget compared to the static budget. Okay, remember you have to know how to prepare the flexible budget. Okay, this is an example, but this is a very okay, this in this starting from this slide, you have to read this slide carefully. Starting from this slide, and then this slide. And then this slide. These three slides shows why flexible budget is better compared to the static budget. It shows that if you use flexible budget, you will make a better conclusion when you compare the actual data and the budgeted data. If you use static budget, sometimes when you compare the actual data and the budgeted data, it does not show the actual thing that happened to your department, because the static budget does not change when the quantity of production is changing. Okay, this is a sample question for the flexible budget. Okay, this is the next thing. Okay, and another one, another thing that is related to flexible budget is a document called performance report. Okay, performance report is a document that shows the comparison between the actual cost and the budgeted cost. The performance report can be prepared at the end of an accounting year or an accounting period. In that document, you can see the difference between the actual cost and the budgeted cost. Sometimes the difference is favorable, sometimes the difference is unfavorable. It depends. Let's say the budgeted sales is 1 million, the actual sales is $1,050,000. So that the difference is $50,000 favorable. It is a good difference. There is nothing to worry about it. A manager should be happy about it. But let's say the direct material cost, the budgeted data is $500,000. Okay, that is the budgeted direct material cost. But the actual direct material cost is $525,000. There is a $25,000 difference. And that difference is unfavorable, because the actual cost is higher than the budgeted cost. That is an unfavorable difference. I hope I can show you, I can prepare a video to show you how to do the performance report later. Okay, this is another thing that you have to know. In this topic, it is about master budget. A master budget is I think it is widely used In most businesses will prepare a master budget. Master budget is like this. Master budget is a link of many budgets. Okay, see here. This is the master budget. It contains many small budgets. So when a company want to prepare a master budget, the company will start with preparing the sales budget. In the sales budget, the company has to estimate how many quantity of sales. For next year, for example, you have a business, you want to prepare, let's say you want to prepare a budget for the month of August 2020. Okay, let's say we make it a monthly budget. So you want to make a master budget for the month of August 2020. So you have to prepare the budget starting from now before the month is started. So when you want to prepare the master budget for next month, the first thing that you have to do is to prepare the sales budget. In the sales budget, you have to estimate the quantity and the dollar of sales for the month of August 2020. After you have prepared the sales budget, then you can prepare the production budget. Because let's say your target or budgeted sales is 100,000 units, then after that you can estimate or budget for your production. If next month you want to sell 100,000 units, then you can decide for the production how many units you want to produce. Maybe you want to produce more. If you have to sell 100,000 units next month, you have to produce more than that because you want to keep some stocks. Okay. After you have decided or prepared the production budget is where you set how many units you want to produce for the next month. After you have set that in the production budget, you can prepare the direct material budget, direct labor budget, and factory overhead budget. Because all these three costs are depending on the quantity of production. Okay, after you have prepared the budgets for these three costs, you can prepare cost of goods sold budget. At the same time, you can prepare the selling and admin expenses budget. And the last thing that you have to prepare is the budgeted income statement. Okay, so these are the document, the budgets linked together, and we call them master budget. If you have a business, it is a very good practice to have a master budget. It will help you to manage your business, to coordinate the workers, to have a sense of purpose when you operate your business. So you know what is to achieve for one accounting year or one accounting month. Okay, this is the end of this topic. Thank you very much. You can communicate with me in the comment section.